Well, hello, fabulous people. And here I am. This is so exciting because as I promised you, as we promised you, we're going to get Kevon Tyrre's review.
What's going on, y'all? How you doing?
Of Captain Marvel.
All right, so...
Yes, but before we make a review on Captain Marvel, I would like to congratulate you. I would like to take this opportunity to promote Kevon Tyrre's music video.
Oh, I see.
Yes, yeah, that type of stuff.
That type of stuff.
Yeah. Which we're going to show to you guys on the after the second segment.
All right. Well, I appreciate that. You know, we premiered it last week, and you know, I haven't really checked out how many people have been checking it out. That in the lyric video, because right now I'm just on push.
Yes.
And hopefully you guys will like it and enjoy it, and hopefully you'll share and comment and like and repeat.
Yes,
you know?
Yes. This is actually a pre-recorded video. We just got back from the movies because I just wanted to see... You know me, I love to watch movies over and over again with my friends.
Yes.
Just to see their facial expressions. Uh-huh. I mean, I'm not watching at the screen anymore, but I'm watching my friends. And I totally... had so much fun watching Captain Marvel with our director producer Maria Peressa.
Yes.
And like her scream was like on point, and she even screamed in some parts that I wasn't expecting her to scream, but that was awesome. That was really awesome.
Okay. I dig that. Yeah, you know, she was just all about, kick their butts.
And, yes, kick their butts. And then I loved when she was like covering her eyes in like some scenes, like there was a monster about to attack them.
Oh, I thought that was the flirking with the cat eating up people. Or,
No. We're not doing.
All right.
We're not doing spoilers. Well, he just spilled it.
I spilled one spoiler. So sorry about that.
So, What did we think of the movie?
I actually thought the movie was okay.
Okay.
You know, I thought the movie was okay. And first off, I want to say that obviously all the people that were in the movie were tops. They were all very good at their job.
Yes.
I thought Brie Larson was good. Nick Fury is always good. It's always good to see Sam Jackson doing his stuff.
Yeah.
Obviously it was, as we know, set in the 90s and all that stuff. And I dug all that. That was very cool. Since we're not getting into spoilers, I will say that I like the spin that they put on it, based on the material that the comic book did. But Marvel's always been good for that. They always will take something and kind of put it on its head a little bit.
Yes.
Just to keep it fresh.
Okay.
And they didn't disappoint in this instance, so I thought they did that very well. But ultimately, I found the movie a bit underwhelming.
A bit underwhelming. All right.
I just felt that the pacing felt a little slow, and that the overall beats they went to certain places were not as... I just weren't able to get into it. I guess that's the best way to say it.
Okay.
But did I enjoy myself? So I think it was a good movie. Yes, I did.
Yeah.
I thought it was a fun movie to watch. Definitely one for girls to watch. I'm definitely taking my kid to see it. So that is hands down, I'm definitely going to take her to watch that so she can watch girls beat up people.
The thing that I get what you're saying, but I'm really disappointed the most is the theater that we've been to was very underwhelming. And the screen seemed unusually tiny.
It
was like already a tiny screen to begin with, and they only... showed like a bit of the screen, and on top was like that black thing.
Well, let's put this in some context, because we were actually have a disagreement about
debate.
This.
Yeah, little
right
debate.
Now he's watched movies for years. He's watched both IMAX and regular.
Yeah,
and he likes the IMAX for these type of movies, the DC Marvel comic book stuff, because he wants that big pop.
Yeah.
For myself, I like to be up front, like four or five rows into the screen, they get that big experience. Doesn't matter what the
and I totally understand that.
Right.
And now that I've been to the theater, I would agree with you, simply because the screen was so underwhelming. not only was the screen underwhelming, look at this, we're doing a theater review.
It does go to the experience. Yeah. It does go for a lot of people. That's, it goes
the screen was underwhelming, and the color was underwhelming.
Right, right. For you it was.
And the brightness, the clarity, and everything was so underwhelming, because the first time that I've seen this movie at the IMAX and on the JBX, it was like a wow experience.
Right, but keep this in mind, and, watching it from IMAX to standard, obviously there's going to be a decrease in quality because of how the thing is.
This was below standard.
Right, now for me, the quality, obviously it was my first time watching it, but for me the quality of it was just a regular screen, regular movie screen. Yeah. So for me, the colors and all that was not the issue, it was just... Can I relate to this story? Can I relate to the characters?
Right, right.
Can I emote with them or what they're going through? Yeah. And those are the things that was
and
was
that
big for
that
me.
I totally understand as as well, but I think that it wouldn't have been that underwhelming had it been on an IMAX screen.
I don't know. I mean, I'm sure there are very underwhelming movies in IMAX. You know?
No, but. This type of movie, like, it was like a balls out sci-fi movie, and at the IMAX screen it was like so amazing.
Every comic book movie in one form or another is a sci-fi movie.
Yeah, but it's, I mean, this theater, I mean, he doesn't believe me because he hasn't seen a movie in IMAX yet, so
I guess
I'm going to have to do something.
I'm not gonna say that because I'll put it this way.
Yeah.
If you see a movie, right, that you think is so-so, right? Now, the quality of the picture could be good, the quality of the actors could be good, but how it was executed could be so-so. Do you think the bigger picture quality will make that movie better? Now, here's another thing.
Okay.
If you see a movie, say in a movie theater, and you see a movie at home, that sometimes makes the movie better. Because some movies are just not meant for the theater.
That's
not to say that Captain Marvel isn't that. So that's not what I'm saying.
Yeah.
But I'm saying that there's some movies that just don't translate that well in the movie theater that translate better at home.
Okay.
To your point, some movies in IMAX would translate better to the standard regular movie theater.
Okay.
For me, and obviously I would have to watch it to compare it, which I will do for you.
Where are you going to watch it?
I'll probably do it at the Palms because it's closer to my house.
Okay.
So I'll probably do it there just so I can, have that debate with you.
Yeah.
But my opinion
what particular
is,
theater are you going to watch it in?
Oh, I'm going to go to the Palms.
Okay. Going to the IMAX?
Well, we were talking about IMAX, so I'll have to see it in IMAX just so we can have a level playing field of seeing it the way you've seen it.
Yes.
To have that point of view.
Yeah.
You know, but my working idea of right now is if the movie's good, it's gonna be good.
That's right. No, that I totally agree. If the movie is good, it's gonna be good.
Right.
I mean, obviously this movie isn't for everyone. It just hit me in a very, you know, deep way. Mm-hmm. And but then go again, I can't shake off the fact that the theater was underwhelming. Like, it was so, like, unbelievably underwhelming that I could see, believe it or not, I could see the unevenness of the screen.
Yeah, and I get that.
I saw the unevenness of the screen, and it was a little bit dark.
Mm-hmm.
And it wasn't standard screen. It was, I was so shocked and disappointed for it to be Red Rock. It's supposed to be a bougie place.
Right, a high-end area.
You know, a bougie neighborhood, and this is what we get. So, Regal, you better, you know.
Well, like, for me, I just found it to be just, you know, call me old school, call me old fashioned. The screen, like the regular screening that they usually use, for me that's not like there was a hole in it. It's not like they had the little lines and the dots in it, like they had from back in the day.
Yeah.
It was still, you know, as far as how the movie was filmed on the screen, it was polished, it was bright, the colors that the directors and them wanted to give the movie, they gave to the distributors, to the theater people, for people to see that. So it was just a matter of, You know, right. Obviously it goes back to preference. Yeah. And the movie is it's a good movie.
Yeah.
You know, it's a well-done movie with great actors. Yes. So everyone should check it out at least once. But okay. I will be honest enough, outside of the IMAX thing that I will do, if it wasn't for that, I would probably see this movie only once. Yeah. I would not see it a second time. You know?
Okay. Right. Well, you know what? Since it was underwhelming to you, I wouldn't force you to watch it again at the IMAX.
No. Because we already brought up the thing of the IMAX experience versus the regular movie experience. Yeah. So I have to watch it in the IMAX experience.
You're going to see Endgame at the IMAX.
Oh, no. I'm going to see that regardless. That I'm going to watch regardless.
Yeah.
But I want to see if your perspective is correct. So maybe I could like it with the bigger screen and the bigger sound and the lights and to have those things pop more will maybe give me a better experience.
Yeah.
My working theory is no, but it doesn't mean I'm correct.
Yeah.
So how am I going to prove that? By going
for myself. I totally agree with you. I mean, the story is the story and you cannot do anything with it.
Right.
But in terms of the visual eye candy aspect of it,
okay,
it really delivered. In IMAX, the visual eye candy aspect and the immersive aspect and the else and the sound, it really contributes to it.
That I will, though, that I will agree with because I've seen Avengers, the first Avengers, I saw that in 3D. And that was obviously surround sound.
Okay.
And that, you know, now watch, everyone knows the replayability of that movie.
All
right,
so hold that thought for a second. So we will be right back for the second segment. And so don't go away.